his mighty power at work within us. Now, what is it saying here, through his mighty power? Well, let's break down that word might. Understand this here. That word mighty comes from the word might, M-I-G-H-T, which means, in the word, biblically, that word might means unlimited power. Unlimited power. Right there, even in that same passage of text in Ephesians 3, verses 14 through 21, Paul prays a prayer. He says, Lord, empower me with your might. So whenever you pray and you ask God to empower you with his might, you're saying, Lord, give me the ability to do all things. Give me unlimited power, unlimited ability, limitless power. This is why we call God, God Almighty, because we're saying, God, your power is limitless. And see, Paul, as a human being, just like you and I, he prayed that prayer, and you know what? The Lord empowered him with might. Guess what? This is why he was able to say in Philippians 4 and 13, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Why? Because he prayed and asked God to give him might. Guess what, my friend? I want to declare over your life right now that God is giving you might. God is giving you the ability to do all things. You ought to say that right now, right where you are. Lord, I thank you that I can do all things. Thank you that power working in me is limitless. Now, it's not us that has the power, watch this here, or unlimited power. It's not us alone. It's the hand of God on our life that gives us the power. It's God living in us that gives us the unlimited ability to live and produce great things. The Bible tells us in 1 John 4 and 4, greater is he who is in us than he that is in this world. Listen to me, my brother. Listen to me, my sister. You're believing that God is going to do exceedingly abundantly above all you can ask or think according to the power that worketh in you. What kind of power is working in you? Unlimited power. From who? From God. It's not your own ability. In fact, if you look at Deuteronomy 8 and 18, take a verse before that, Deuteronomy 8 and 17, it declares that one would say in his heart that it is my power and my ability that has given me the ability to produce wealth. But then the next verse, verse number 18 says, but you must remember the Lord your God, for it is him who gives you the power to produce wealth. See, one would say that it's their own power and their own ability. That's the greatest mistake that any of us could ever make, is to think that the blessing that's on our life came from us, or the success that we have came from us, or the miracles that we see happening in our lives come from our own ability. That's the greatest way to stay out of position to receive the greater blessing from the Lord. This is why, even in the New Living Translation of Ephesians 3 and 20, the Bible says now, it begins, giving all glory to God who is able. All glory to the Father who is able. Jehovah Jireh, he's the one who provides. Jehovah Shalom, he's the one who gives us peace. Jehovah Rapha, he's the one who heals. Hello, somebody. I'm telling you right now, God is the one who gives us the ability to have great success. Now, it's according to the power that's working in us, but we must first yield to that power. There's no way. There's no way, my friend, and hear me loud and clear, that you will see the exceedingly, the abundantly, the above all you can ask or think. You'll never see it manifest if you don't yield to God's power working in you. And then when you recognize that that power is working in you, then you've got to work the power. You put the power to work now. This is why the word tells us in the book of James that like a body without a spirit is dead, so is faith without works dead. You got to work that faith. You got to work that power that's in you. And I don't care where you are. I don't care what you've done. I don't care how many mistakes you've made. I don't care. I don't care how old you are, how young you are. Listen, there is no age limit to the blessings of the Lord. You may be listening to me right now and you say, well, Pastor Marcus, I'm in my 30s. I'm in my 40s, my 50s, my 60s, maybe my 70s, maybe even your 80s. And you're watching me right now. And you say, well, what is God going to do new in my life? How is God going to open new doors in my life? What is God going to change in my life? It's too late. Listen to me. The devil is a liar. You are never too old for God to do a new thing in you. You are never too old for your dreams to come true. I declare right now, you are blessed beyond measure, and God is getting ready to bless you beyond your wildest dreams. But you are never too old for God to do a new thing in you. You're never too old to see your dreams manifest themselves. Don't you dare start feeling like, oh, you've come to the end of your road and your creative ability is gone. And, you know, every door that could have opened, those doors aren't going to open anymore. It's too late for all that. The devil is a liar. You are alive and well, and you hold the key to the greatest door coming open in your life. Doors of opportunities are still available for you. You know what? I think about this story. And it'll probably make you laugh a little bit, but it's so true and it's so powerful. When I released my first book back in 2015, it was called Single God Life. And I wrote this book to encourage singles and dating on, you know, kind of how to hear from God and how to prepare for your soulmate, for your husband or for your wife. And soon after I released that book and it had gone all over, I got a message, an email from a dear lady. And in the message, she let me know that she was 74 years old. She let me know that she had read my book and the book had blessed her. And she also let me know, watch this, at 74 years old, she said, "I'm excited about meeting my husband." Oh my goodness, you can't tell me. You can't tell me I didn't get excited when I read that. 74 years old, encouraged, uplifted, inspired, and yet gonna say, "I'm believing for my husband." And so as I begin to travel and do more singles conferences, I'm talking to folks that's in their 20s and 30s and they're complaining and fussing about how they can't wait no longer and they're tired of waiting and all this stuff. And when I told that story, everybody was shocked. And I said, "You no longer have an excuse to be talking about you can't wait and you're only in your 30s. And here's a 74-year-old woman still believing God for her husband." Listen to me, my friend. It is never too late for God to bless you. It's never too late for God to do a new thing in your life. It's never too late for God to turn that thing around. And I'm telling you, he's doing it for you right now. There's something happening in the spirit realm. You probably can't see it right now, but you're going to see it real soon. In fact, if you take your faith to the next level, what you can't see with your natural eyes, you can begin to see with your spiritual eyes. And if I were to ask you face to face, has the Lord told you that everything is going to be all right? Has the Lord told you he's going to bless you? Has the Lord told you he's going to turn it around? You'd look at me if you've been connected in the spirit and you say, "You know what, man of God, the Lord has told me that everything's going to be all right." Something deep down on the inside of you ought to be stirring up on the inside. See, when I was in my place of not knowing how I was going to come out and how I was going to grow and how things were going to begin to manifest, you know, my grandparents and my parents and even my younger brothers will always encourage me and say, "Marcus, it's going to be all right. Keep working. Keep pressing. Your dreams are going to come true. Your dreams are going to become your reality." And you know, you may not have somebody in your life right now to tell you that. You might not have somebody in your house or somebody to give you a call. You may be feeling like nobody cares and you're in this thing by yourself and you just need somebody to encourage you. Listen, this is why the Lord allowed you to see this program. Whether you're watching me on television or you're watching me online, the Lord allowed you to tune into this program. This was no accident, because he wants you to know, I haven't left you, and I'll put somebody in your life to speak this word into existence. And I'm being used by God right here, right now, for somebody, for a man, for a woman. I'm speaking to you. You haven't heard from anybody else, but you're going to hear it from me. You are blessed beyond measure. Those are five words I want you to declare over yourself every morning when you wake up. You just say, "I am blessed beyond measure." Five words. Five is the number of grace. You declare that over yourself. Matter of fact, speak it right now, right where you are. Say it out loud. "I am blessed beyond measure." Now, whenever you declare that you are blessed beyond measure, you know what you're saying? You're saying God is able to bless me in unlimited fashion. There's no shortage in heaven. There's never going to be a time where God is going to run out of blessings. Listen to this scripture again. I want to read the rest of this to you from the New Living Translation, Ephesians 3 and 20. What's our scripture? Ephesians 3 and 20 from the New Living Translation. Again, "Now all glory to God, who is able through his mighty power at work within us to accomplish," watch this here, "infinitely more than we might ask or think." Infinitely. Infinity, no limit. It will never stop. I don't care how big your dream is. God can still do greater. God can always do greater. And the greatest part about this scripture, I love it. It says God is able. But I like to take my faith a step further, even in that declaration, and just speak it. God is able, yes. But guess what? He loves you so much. Therefore, God is willing. He's able and he's willing to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all you can ask or think, according to the power that works in you. Now, what are you going to believe for today? What are you believing for right here, right now, from wherever you're watching me from all over the world? What are you believing God for? Are you going to fully trust him? Like the Bible says in Proverbs chapter number 3, verses 5 and 6, "Trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not to your own understanding. In all of your ways, acknowledge God and he's going to direct your paths." Are you going to trust God or are you going to trust yourself? Are you going to trust the negative words of maybe some faithless people that may be around you? See, that's why this is important. When you're believing God for big things, you got to be around people who think big, who believe big, who trust God in big ways. Because if you're connected to people who don't think big, who don't trust God in big ways, they're going to always discourage you. And they're going to talk you out of believing God for what you're believing for. They're going to cause you to want to water down your faith, water down your prayers, and then in turn, water down the blessing. Watering down your expectations because they don't believe. You got to get around some people that are full of faith. Some people that are full of the anointing, full of power. Some folks that aren't afraid to believe God for what man thinks is impossible. As children of God, we know that with God, anything is possible. There's nothing our God cannot do. If the walls in your house are red and you tell God, Lord, what color are my walls? And the Lord says your walls are blue. Before you can say, Lord, no, they're not. You'll look and your walls will be blue because that's the kind of power that God has. There's nothing broken that God can't fix. There's no sickness that God cannot heal. There's no relationship that God can't bring together. And listen, if there are people watching me right now and you're in an abusive relationship, there's no abusive relationship that God can't give you a way of escape and bring you up and out of that thing. Hello, somebody. There's no financial trouble that God can't turn into wealth and overflow. There's no unsaved family member that God can't save, deliver and set free and then turn around and use them for his glory. Is there anything too hard for God? Now unto him who's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can ask or think according to the power that worketh in us. Infinite ability, unlimited power, and that power is working in you right now. You see, when you stick to the word, see, this isn't the word of just some great orator or a great writer. These aren't the words that I've dreamt of and then come up with and gotten creative just to share with you because it sounds good. No. This is the word of God. Are you hearing me, somebody? The word that will never change, the word that will never be destroyed, the word that will never be, watch this here, challenged and proven to fail. Never. The word of God. And when you stick to the word, you'll always come out with a testimony. I believe that if you're believing God for the, watch this here, immeasurable results, above and beyond what you can control, above and beyond what you can even explain. You know, when God blesses us, we end up like Peter, with joy unspeakable and full of glory. If you're trusting God for something huge right now, believe me, my friend, it's going to happen for you. And it's going to happen for you in ways greater than what you could ever dream or imagine. Don't you give up. Young people, seasoned people, everyone watching, married folks, single folks, saved, even if you haven't come to the Lord just yet, I'm believing God with you right now that you're going to come to the Lord. You're going to come to know Jesus as your personal Savior. In fact, if you're watching me right now and you say, I don't know the Lord and I want to give my life to Jesus, I want you to call that number at the bottom of the screen. And let one of our team members lead you to Christ. You call that number right now, 1-888-587-LIFE. Again, that's 1-888-587-LIFE. One of our team members is going to answer that call for you, and I want you to let them know, I want to give my life to Jesus, and they're going to lead you in the prayer of salvation. If you're believing God for healing in your body right now, because I'm getting ready to pray, you say, God, I need you to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all the doctor has said. And you're believing God for healing. I'm getting ready to pray, but I want you to connect with one of our prayer partners. Call that number at the bottom of the screen. Somebody's going to pray with you. If you're believing God for your marriage or for your family, for your children, maybe you're believing God for a financial miracle and you just want somebody who believes in the exceedingly, the abundantly, above all we can ask or think, somebody who's got great faith, you call that number at the bottom of the screen. Let one of our team members touch and agree with you right now. As you're believing God for your miracle, as you're believing God for your breakthrough, I declare that your time is right now. And I'm going to pray for you right now. Whatever you're believing God for, I want to connect my faith with yours. And I want to believe God with you and for you that nothing but the absolute best is yet to come. What did I say before? 5 words to declare over your life. A 5-word sentence. I am blessed beyond measure. You declare those words over your life every day and watch God manifest himself richly in your life. Call that number at the bottom of the screen if you want one-on-one prayer with one of our team members. And I want you to receive this word of prayer right now. Can I pray for you? Let's believe God together at this moment. Father, I just thank you and I praise you for these, your precious people. And I thank you for every man and every woman that's watching me right now from all over the world, from coast to coast and around the world. These, your precious people, have received this message of encouragement. Father, we are trusting you for big things. We're trusting you, oh God, for great things. And God, I believe right now that according to our faith, you'll move. According to what we see and what we expect, you're going to move on our behalf. And so, Father, I thank you right now for moving for these, your precious people. Father, there's a man watching right now who needs a miracle. There's a woman watching right now, oh God, who needs a miracle. There are families represented right now that need a turnaround. Father, there are some that need healing in their body. I pray right now, God, that you would heal, deliver, and set them free.